Giants football, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
And all the way down to the 36-yard line. It's a big play there for Atlanta. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Here's Ryan. And he'll complete this one to Patterson. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Time, but it's going to lead to third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Again, Ryan. And he's going to have the hook up to Gage. And he is going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Going to give this time to the tailback. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 54 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive, and here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. And that'll set him back 5. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. Still a nice 13-yard pickup.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though. But we always talk about good down and distance, allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Cordarrelle Patterson taking it in from a yard out. And the Falcons are an extra point away from moving out in front. call is to go for one and kick the extra point. He's got it, and they take the lead at 7-6. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. This Philly offense set to go. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
Third quarter now, to one-point game as they line up second and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. And this is caught by Watkins. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. It's Eric Harris who picks it, and they'll have the ball set up in the red zone at the 16-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
They'll throw on first down with Ryan. His throw incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
Second and 10, it's Ryan again. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And the Falcons are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Will score. Touchdown, Atlanta. Oh, CD, there didn't seem to be much resistance there down near the goal line.
Yeah, partner, from what I saw there, not a real good job of matching up defensively, because to me, they looked like they were just in their base 3-4 package. You need bigger bodies in there in a goal line type situation. The 3-4, fine between the 20s, but not down here when you're guarding your end zone.
Koo able to connect on the extra point, and that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a 2-point conversion to tie it. Taking it about the one. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one-possession game, down eight. They'll be looking for the touchdown and two-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped.
And that's a much-needed first down right there. Look, they're down by eight. So logic says they don't have to get a touchdown out of this drive. But the way things are going, I don't know if I'd put it in the hands of my defense here. You might not get the ball back at all. So if a fourth down situation comes up.
There he goes, right side. 91 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. So they had it bottled up, able to make a man miss, and then boom, off to the races.
And it's how he made him miss. A little bit of strength, too. Had to work through contact to get him off of him. And then once he did that, now he put his agility to use and took off.
And Sanders on first down with a little bit of space as he works his way forward. A gain of four.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They go play action with Hurts. Being chased out left. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. They tried to go with a little play action there, but nobody on the defensive side bit.
Yeah, they adjusted in time and in a big way and ultimately got the sack. On offense, sometimes you're running play action just to set up a certain blocking technique. In this case, none of it worked.
Forced out to his left. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. But he's got his man. It's the tight end, Goddard. And the Eagles are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. First and goal, a touchdown and a two-point conversion here are musts. Sanders. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the three. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, I have to think that the wheels are really spinning in their play caller's mind now. That little setback there on first down. They'll have three more shots if that's what it takes, because they've got to take field goals out of their thought process. They need a touchdown and a conversion to tie this game. What play calls does he have on that sheet?
Sanders again. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
So it's third and goal, and now the question, can this Falcon defense stand tall once more? They'll try to run with Sanders. And looking for a lane, but none to be found for Sanders as they stop him short of the line to gain. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. Going to take the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They come up on the play of the game now. Fourth and goal. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Falcons able to muster together a goal line stand. So now let's reset here, Charles. They do have two timeouts left, so they can stop the clock twice. This one's not quite over yet.
No, and what you're doing on defense, you're going to use both timeouts, obviously. But you've got to call defenses are going to force the issue early, meaning you want that play over fast. You don't want to give them time to dance around in the backfield or run a wide sweep that'll take off time. Blitz them, put pressure on them, make sure that play ends quickly so that you can go ahead and keep moving.
And he takes this just about a yard shy of the 20. 69 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Once more, they turn to Patterson. He's got a first down past the 30, and he'll be out right at the 35. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as he'll get it with still a minute 20 left to go in the game. Now flags come flying in. One of the Falcons moved early. The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
False start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. They'll get four on second down, but it leaves them with third and still nine to go. Now a timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Third down, it's Patterson. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero.